Right, it's Sunday the 31st of May, day two of liberation for the battery hens, and they're in a pretty poor state. I went and got 20 something yesterday. Right, here we go. These are four girls that can't stand and can't walk due to their year of living in a tiny cramped cage where they were probably trodden on by other chickens. Trodden on by other chickens and not able to stand. At the moment they can't stand. They seem pretty on the ball. They can eat and drink, as you can see, flopped over combs, and alert enough, but absolutely no muscle in their legs at all. So they're laying in the sun for the vitamin D, which will help strengthen their bones. They have got wheat sprinkled around. They are eating, and they're near the water container, so they can drink if they need to drink. Here we go. Hello, chicken. Hello, chicken. So yes, all of them pretty bald, as you can see. Some of them much balder than others. That here is completely naked skin. She's got just a few tufts of feathers. There you go, naked chicken skin. There's a price to be paid for cheap eggs in supermarkets, and these are the creatures that pay it. In here, more birds looking thoroughly miserable and bewildered. They had a traumatic day yesterday, being ripped out of the battery cages and transported across Norfolk to a place where I went and collected them from, and then transported from there to here. And I hope they'll find it a nicer place to live. As you can see, one of them is already starting to scratch, which is why the straw's on the ground. The straw put on the ground and wheat scattered in amongst the straw to try and encourage the scratching instinct, which will strengthen her leg muscles, which is absolutely brilliant. Most of them have very pale pink combs, and the combs are flopped over, which is not normal in normal chickens. And if I swivel around to the pen, which contains my odds and sods, including my old ex-battery chickens, which are now over 5 years old, you can see the difference. Upright comb, quite happily pecking around, full of feathers, a lot happier, in other words. But this lot should end up like this. Hello, chicken. Some of them are brighter than others, but very pale. Pale legs, limping, just not very strong. As I say, right old mess. Most of them have got feathers missing. If I can get in close to that. You've got no feathers at all on her bum. There you go. Right old mess. Let's see if we can get any more around here. Hello, girls. They have a perch in, but they wouldn't perch. Not at this stage. Their claws aren't strong enough. Let's see. Quite weak, not used to standing up at all. Hey. They'll stand up for a little bit, the weaker ones, and then they go down again. But this is the price of cheap eggs, folks. Some of them round here in the shade. There we go. There we are. Hello, girl. And again, this semi-squatting stance, and just barely able to walk. It's as though if you kept a child tied in a chair for the first few years of its life, and there was just no muscle, there's no leg muscle. There we go. Right, here we go, poppets. So hopefully, this is quite a nice place for them. They're right next to the flock that they will eventually join through there. So they'll get to know each other through the wire. As you can see, dappled shade, so it won't get too hot. The dappled shade comes from my beautiful walnut tree, which I love, and I planted approximately 5 years ago. So altogether a nice spot for them, spacious, enough space for them to get used to walking around, patch of sunshine for them to lay in if they want. Those four girls there are the ones that concern me most. But I've no doubt they'll be fine if I can get them up. I'm coming up several times a day to do physiotherapy, making them stand basically. So that should be all right. But please, please, please stop buying cheap supermarket battery eggs. The cost might be cheap to you, but it's a hell of a cost to these. And no living creature deserves to end up like these. There we go. What have we got here? We got a... No, you're not going out. We've got a barber down there in there with some chicks. Let's have a look. She's an excellent broody. But she's not a very good mother, and she tends to lose her chicks, which literally become very lost then, because cats get them. Where's your babies? And over here are my girls. That's Betty on the left, Phoebe on the right. Along there is Louise with her kid Helen, and her other kid Daniel. She rejected Daniel, so he was bottle fed. There we go. There we go. No gartyard, no full of rubbish in there. Some poo because I haven't cleaned up this morning yet. This yard gets swept and raked twice a day. There's their platform in the shade underneath the big sycamore. Brilliant. On the hottest weather, that's always in shade there, so it keeps them cool. You've got another pallet platform there if they want to lie in the sun. And lying in the sun and warming up are my girls. It's all right, Josephine. That's Josephine. And down here are the two sisters from Annie. They're the girls. That's Annie died, and that's Penny.